My name is Roma Blaya, and in this video I want to show you how you can use TEI Roma to create a TEI customization. How do you find TEI Roma? So you can find Roma via the TEI website. You can just go to Tools, and there's Roma listed under among the TEI tools. Or you can just Google TEI and Roma, and you will arrive at the same website, I hope. On the landing page, you see a number of radio buttons, which basically allow you to select how you want to start with your customization. Either you can create a customization from scratch, or you can use or you can upload a customization from your computer, or you can use already existing TEI customization and modify it. I will do exactly this and start. Alright, here I need to provide a bit of information about my customization. For instance, I can give it a title. This I say Dariah Teach Customization. I give it a file name. I change the file name to Dariah Teach. And then I can provide a namespace. A namespace is useful to provide a custom namespace is useful when I want to add custom elements. Because custom elements that are not part of the TEI standard need to have their own namespace. This allows me or also other people to distinguish them clearly from TEI elements. So in my TEI document, I see immediately which elements are part of the TEI standard and which not. Then I give my name as author, and I can also provide a description, but I won't do this now. Always hit save. Okay, perfect. I can also choose language settings. Next, I have to modify the modules. I can either include or remove modules in this section. My current customization has already a couple of modules included over here on the right side. On the left side, you see a list of all TEI modules. TEI modules are basically groupings of elements. If I want to add or remove individual elements, I basically click on the TEI on this module name, TEI module name, and there I have basically the possibility to include or exclude individual elements. And I can also change the attribute settings over here. So next, I want to show you how you can add a custom element. So I would like, for instance, to create an element that is called furniture name, which is not part of the TEI at the moment. I enter a name up here. Then I have my already defined custom namespace down here. And next, I provide a short description saying, okay, is used to tag furniture names. Here we go. Maybe I also have to add a model class. Model class, again, groupings of elements. Furniture name is basically a name. So I add then the name-like model. I could also add attribute classes, which would basically allow me to assign groups of attributes to my custom element. And next, I have to give information about the content. What kind of content do I want to have in my element? And I want it to be data name content. Always hit save, and here we have my custom element. I can again change attributes or add new attributes, but I won't do this now. And I can certainly also delete the element. Next, I can also change the attribute classes. I can basically add or remove, include or exclude individual attributes from my custom schema. I can export my schema in different ways, either as a DTD or as RelaxNG, and I will export the schema now as RelaxNG with XML syntax. generation takes a little bit. Yep. Takes a few seconds. And there it is. I save my new custom schema. I have it here already saved. Okay, let's save it again. Perfect. So next I can also download documentation if I want to. I can download documentation in form of a web page, or I can download it also as DIODD, which basically means one document does it all. And this is the standard way of how TI documents, how a DI project should document the customization. So every TI project should have a ODD. I can also save my customization, but I won't do this now. All right, next I would like to show you how I can include my customization into a simple TI document. So here I have my TI document. I have the header section, I have the text section down here. But as you see, there is no processing instruction that assigns a schema to this document. Oxygen allows me to do this with a wizard. I can go here on document schema and then I hit associate schema. And here in this pop-up box, I basically find the schema that I just generated. And as you see, Oxygen already assigns this schema type. It's a relax-ng XML syntax. And then I hit OK. And Oxygen will actually provide the schema, the path to the schema for me right here. So how can I see now that my customization actually worked? I can try now to look for furniture name, and here we have our custom element, furniture name. And when you see when I include this furniture name element now, and I have to add also some text into it, perfect. The Oxygen validator tells me that this is a valid TI document. And you can see here on the furniture name element, there is this custom namespace that we created just before. This is required because it basically it says that this element does not belong to the TI namespace, which is declared up here on the root element. All elements following the root element have this specific TI namespace, which is declared on the root element. But an element that does not belong to this TI namespace has to have the namespace declaration on the element itself. If I remove this namespace declaration, for instance, you will see that Oxygen throws me an error saying that this element is not allowed because it's not part of the TI namespace.